Tonight on Versus, two extreme elements are getting into a chemistry cage match. Will frosty liquid nitrogen freeze out the competition? Or will sizzling lava crank up the heat? Which liquid will come out on top? It's liquid nitrogen versus lava. They say opposites attract, but that's not the case for these two. These chemical competitors couldn't be more different, and we've got front row seats in the vicious volcano arena. But don't get too close. It's safe to say that this will be one severe showdown. Let's bring out the contenders. In this corner, it's liquid nitrogen! Today, we use liquid nitro for everything from freezing and transporting food to acting as a coolant for superconductors. Liquid nitrogen boils at temperatures of minus 196 degrees Celsius, meaning you should think twice about touching the stuff. Liquid nitrogen can freeze living tissue, leading to frostbite or even losing a body part. This element also has a volume expansion ratio of 1 to 694. So when liquid nitrogen boils and becomes a gas, its volume expands by 694 times. Translation? Boom! But it'll take a lot more than hazy vapors and the rock bottom of a thermometer to threaten liquid nitrogen's fiery foe. In this corner, bringing the heat to the highest degree is lava. Named after the Roman god of fire, Vulcan, volcanoes are a force to be reckoned with. Approximately 500 million people live close to active volcanoes. Scorching mafic magma is often found in Hawaii and can reach over 1,093 degrees. But lava's searing heat is only the tip of the iceberg. Tip of the volcano. Depending on its viscosity and how steep the slope is, lava can ooze along at speeds of up to 30 kilometers per hour, destroying almost anything it touches. And if that wasn't scary enough, this extreme substance often stays incandescent, holding in its heat for about 50 years if it's thick enough. These reactionary rivals are ready to rumble, but only one opponent can take the chemical crown. Let the games begin! Fight! The liquid nitrogen stalks toward the lava, making use of its odorless, colorless properties. But it'll take much more than stealth to take down this extra hot enemy. Exposure to room temperature causes liquid nitro to start scattering and dissipating. Known around the ring as the Leidenfrost phenomena, liquid nitrogen's boiling point is far colder than lava's, causing it to dance across the lava's surface and evaporate. This incredibly cold chemical is going to need backup, but how much will it take? Luckily, this leisurely lava's got time to kill, as volcanoes can continuously erupt for years. The liquid nitrogen struggles to approach its competitor, let alone freeze it. The liquid nitrogen starts to expand, threatening to explode. But it's not enough. With its larger volume comes a larger risk. This cold contender just can't handle the heat and vanishes into the atmosphere as a vapor. The winner is the lava! Though we witnessed extremes on both ends of the temperature spectrum, tonight's match had a clear winner. If there had been enough liquid nitrogen moving with enough speed, it might have taken the win by freezing the lava back into stone. But the resilient and bountiful lava was a flaming force to be reckoned with. It was a race to the finish, and while the liquid nitrogen moved fast, the slow and steady lava outlasted its foe and won the race. Next time, we're bringing this battle of fire and ice to a new arena. It's your body. That's right, it's frostbite versus heatstroke. We'll see who wins on another round of Versus.